Sometimes people won't go to a therapist because there's long been a stigma about mental health. And we often see that there is a bit of a kind of a John Wayne, you know, true grit mentality that says, if I get back up on my horse and I get moving forward, then I'm going to be okay. When we think about mental health awareness in the Mountain West, it has been helpful to have people like Marie Osmond be able to come out and talk about some of her challenges that she's had, because it puts a face to the mother who has, you know, 7, 8, 9 children and sometimes needs some help to be able to move through some difficult stages in life. It's been helpful to be able to have Tanner Mangum come out, somebody who looks like they have the world by the tail, and have the bravery to be able to say, sometimes I suffer from depression. And to the outside observer, that wouldn't always make sense. And those things are really critical to helping people in our culture be able to identify with mental health challenges. In 2009, Congress passed the Mental Health Parity Act. And unbeknownst to a lot of consumers, mental health got on par with insurances by law with medical. And so what that means is if you break your arm, your insurance company has to see that as a medical issue and pay for it. And also, if you're diagnosed with depression or anxiety, or you're on the spectrum, or you're going through a life's challenge, a transition issue, things that many of us deal with, those are seen legally through your insurance plan as being on par with breaking your arm on your insurance plan. And so many, many people have insurance that covers outpatient mental health benefits and even inpatient mental health benefits, and they don't even know it. There is no mental health rider anymore, because it's seen as on par with your medical benefits. And that can be a big boost to people who aren't aware of that.